Hey everybody, and welcome back to Fallout 4. I'm Izzy Smith, and we're here in Sanctuary. I got Kate with me. I've got dog meat around here somewhere. And the sun is coming up. It's a beautiful day. And there's the factory we just got done building over there. And Kate's humming. Someone's humming. And Carla's Brahmin's going crazy. Anyway, as you can see, we've got a new addition to Sanctuary that has not been in a video. That is Fort Sanctuary that I built. And if you look at it, the reason I didn't make a video for it is because if you compare it to the bunkhouse, it's pretty much the same style of building. So if you watch the bunkhouse video, you get the idea on how to do the fort there. The only difference is the fort's much bigger and the interior is a lot more divided up into different rooms and sections and everything. And I'll have to show you that. Same with the pub, like I mentioned in the other video. This is very simple. This is just your basic. There's nothing in there yet. We haven't decorated it. Today we're going to build a store. And the store I want to build is based on a store that I grew up in my very, very young, early youth. Right up the street from. I lived on the very same street. I come from a very small rural neighborhood out in the middle of the country. And it was a general store and a feed and grain store for the farmers. And you could get groceries there. The farmers would go and get bags of feed for their horses and their cattle and everything like that. And it was run by a man named Mr. Bosler. Mr. Bosler was an older gentleman. He was really nice and friends with my dad. And I actually, let's see, our house was three houses up from the general store. So I could walk down the sidewalk. Dad would give me like a couple of dollars and he'd say, go down there to the store and buy a gallon of milk and get yourself some candy and a soda. And I would just walk right down the street, you know, kindergarten, first grade, and 1, 2, 3, and right there at the door. And I'd go in, Mr. Bosler would greet me and he'd help me get the milk. And I'd pick out my candy, he'd check it out and everything, put it in a little brown paper bag, and then I'd just come running home. So that store always had special memories for me. And then whenever I got older, it was the bus stop. Mr. Bosler passed away and they boarded up the place. And we would walk down there and wait for the bus to come to pick us up to go to school. And we would stand underneath the front wooden sort of awnings on this old dilapidated building, and I would remember going in there, and it was just, it's some of my favorite memories from whenever I was a kid. So I thought I would kind of recreate it for everybody today. And it had a wood front, but it had a metal sides and back. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to recreate that. So the first thing we're going to do is we will go to SKE. We'll get under structures, the same as we've been doing with the alternative settlements mod by Stoyuk, I think you pronounce it. Anyway, we're going to get some of this wood, and this is just the wood, old wood planks. You can't really see it real well there. There you go. It's not really dark. It's just kind of like a regular old wood. And what we're going to do is we're going to start back here. I think it'd be about here. We'll throw a couple of these down, and we're gonna go this direction, we're gonna go this direction. And now what I want to do to recreate the storefront is I'm gonna go out of SKE and I'm gonna go up to just the vanilla. Whoop, don't want to move the steps. Just up to the vanilla structures, go to wood, go to prefabs, and we've got this one prefab that's got like this slanted metal roof that matches. Okay, see, we're a little we're a little too far forward, so we'll just go a little farther back. We'll move these. Not much. We kind of want to get this about even with this, give or take, just a little with that pavement. Let's have a look at it. Yeah, okay, we're real close right there. Let's just move these. We'll come back to them. Yeah, wait a minute. Okay. Just getting warmed up. Kind of want that even with these steps. Because he did have some old concrete steps out front. It also had a gas pump. And it was the old fashioned from like the 50s and 60s. It was an old 76 gas pump. It wasn't like you you see nowadays. All right, so we kind of got that in mind. We want to go on this foundation, we want to stay with just this regular old kind of wood. And these aren't running in the same direction, are they? One of these things is not like the other. There we go. All right. Now, we'll take another one of these and we'll put it like that. Is that right? We want that angle toward the... And that's about how big it was. And then over here, we're just gonna put some old wood, just like we had. So, yeah, it takes it a minute in here. Structures, wood, wood floor. There we are. Okay. Pretty good. Not too bad. We're gonna keep this foundation. All right. Now, I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna pull that up, this first moment, and then we're going to go into the vanilla structures. And over here under the barn, we're gonna use some barn, not that, that's prefab. Okay, we're gonna use some of the barn walls on the front because it was wood. Ah, now see what that's wanting to do. Okay, so actually what I want to do is pull, well, that's kind of the idea, put that one in there, take this one, pull it back out. Sometimes you just gotta manipulate this stuff. It just doesn't want to work with you. And then he had these nice windows that they were kind of concave around the front, but we don't have that in the game. They had these nice little sort of shelves, I guess you would say. But we don't have anything similar to that. I'm debating on that one or these. I think I'll go with these. We'll go ahead and... Yeah, see, that doesn't look quite right. What about this? Come on now, line up. There we are. Yeah, that looks... Yeah, that's much better. Oh, we need a piece of wood back here. Yeah, okay. There we go. Now, put this right back in. If we can figure out. I think that's right. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Okay, oh man, this is already, yeah, it's kind of nice, that's very nice, takes me back. So we would come up here, and we would hang out. I am going to alter it just a little bit, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to have some metal siding on the walls. And normally you would think, well, we would use the warehouse stuff for that, but actually I found under metal I have some of these, which is pretty nice. So we'll use this. We're going to have to put a couple more. Ooh, that's going to be close. I wonder if I'm going to have to move this thing. Let's put down some more foundation. Come on now. Come on, people down. Smile on your brother. Come on. There we go. Okay. Yeah, that might be a little close. I don't know. Getting into that green zone, aren't we? Yeah. Are we going to be able to put a... back walls on that, I wonder. Let's just try. Yep. Man, that is close. I wonder if we can pull... Ooh! I wonder if we can pull the whole thing forward. If I do... it will be a miracle. But let's try it. We are going for, ladies and gentlemen, he's going for the record. Look at that. Look at that. Because what we can do, did that take? That took. Okay, now we just take this foundation and move it up. Okay, are we even? Oh, yes. Look at that. And we're out of the green. Just barely. Hey, all right. That's okay. I like that. That'll work. Yeah. Okay. So, let's see. We're going to finish up putting the floors down. That was kind of a close call. It turned out. Make sure all of these are the grains going the same direction. Once again, we're under SKE, just working with the alternate settlements. Wood. Right there. That nice old wooden floor with those walls like they were. Alright. Okay. Yeah. And we'll put a solid. Let's see. Oh, that's concrete. We want to get back out to the vanilla. Here's the barn structures. We'll go ahead and, well, let's see. What do we got for just a flat wall under metal back here? Without any specific windows. That's not bad. That's not bad. I don't know. We'll do this. We'll try to make it match on both sides. Now, it's kind of not going to matter in places. And I'll tell you why. Because we're going to have a side, kind of a side room, like a storage area. Walls. There we go. And it's going to be off this back side like it used to be whenever I was a kid. Oh, come on. Why can't I? I'm looking right at it. I know I am. Okay. There we go. Ah, these are shorter, aren't they? Okay. Well, if that's the case. Let's see. Why am I looking at the floors there? How much taller is that? That's not gonna work. Let's get rid of those. I don't think we're going to be able to do that. Hey, it was worth a shot, though. We'll stick with the... we'll stick with the barn, then. We'll do this. Try to make it look even. There we are. Yeah, okay. That's nice. I want to look at it from this side. Yeah, see, it doesn't have that metal that the old original place that I recall had. We could use a warehouse. Let's try that. There are no mistakes. There's just happy little accidents in our world. What did Bob Ross say? Something to that effect. Yeah, there's no mistakes. There's just... happy little... Oh... Really? Yeah, I'm out of glass. Oh, well, hang on just a second and we'll fix that. Be right back. And we're back. I went and got some shipments of glass. So that works. Alright, now we're under warehouse, and what we're gonna do is we've got walls now that we can use. I want... sitting here looking at them. Why do I not... Huh. Yeah, okay. Well, I suppose this will work. We'll try it. Because I'm going to have to bring it out this direction with a half piece anyway. I'm not seeing my half piece. Unless it's right in front of me and I'm just blind. There it is. There we go. Now, this will actually be wood. This one will be. Okay. Let's get rid of this part right there. And we'll use a metal door right there. Okay. Now, I don't want that. I want... getting lost in my own goodies here. We want to go back one on this, so we'll go SKE. We'll get another piece of wood. Gotta wait for it to pull it up. There we go. That's dark wood plank. We want just the regular wood plank. Okay, now, we want to jump back. Well, wait a minute, while we're here, let's just go ahead and fill that in. Wood planks. There it is. Okay. That's the ticket. Now we're getting somewhere. We weren't before. Now we are. Okay. So we're gonna go back into the vanilla to the... warehouse, walls, and we want this half one, but we want to put it right up along here. So let's see, we'll move this block just for a minute. Snap that on there. Whoop. Okay. And, don't be cruel. This, like this, around the back. Now we'll go inside and we will take just a regular old warehouse wall. Not a door, just a regular wall, and do like that. Now, for this, we'll go into the roofs. Whoop, warehouse. Roofs. And we'll get these slanted type of roofs. Let's see if my little thing works here. There we go. Put that like that. And go back to walls. This was like a little storeroom that was off of the side of the place where he kept the bags of feed and stuff, I suppose. But yeah. Let's get a look at it. That's nice. Yeah, it's starting to take shape. Okay. Now, what have we got over on that other side? We had this one? Yeah. And then half? Where's the half? There it is. All right. And we'll put some metal walls up all the way around. Wow. Who'd have thought? Now, the thing about it was it was such an old timey store, he even had one of those fronts on it. But I can't, let me look at it. I don't recall. Yeah, that was it. That's great. That's awesome. So we'll go half all the way around. Hey, level 23. All right. I just remember looking up at it whenever I was a kid, the sides and the inside and the walls were really tall. He had that false type of a front to it, but there was a big sort of a shield. It was an advertisement for a corn company. And it was on the outside of the building. And it was right dead center, right about there. It was big round shield. FS, I think it was. Something like that. And we used to throw rocks at it, and it would sound like a gong whenever you'd hit it. Dong! And yeah. Boy, that was many, many years ago. That was back in whenever that happened, we were teenagers, so I guess that would have been in the 80s. But whenever I was a little boy going there, that was the early 70s. I'm talking like 73, 74, 75. Yeah, I'm old. Some of you younger guys watching this will be like, how old is this guy? I'm old. I'm old enough. Alright, we need to find the pieces that'll fill in those little gaps right there. Oh, that's probably in the walls. Let's see. Try this. There we are. Get that. There we go. I remember the rafters had those kind of beams on them, too. He had a really nice house up the road. This was just his store. Oh, wow. Holy cow. Yeah, that looks like it. Sure enough. Wonder if there's something, some kind of a decoration I can put right there that's round and metal. We'll have to see. Alright. So we've got our basic structure here. What can we put out front? I wish there was a gas pumps. Some mod that had a gas pump where I could just plop it down. Like, oh, you know what? Hey now, wait a minute. Ethereon, under Master Plan, the mod maker Ethereon has Red Rocket Reborn, and I just wonder. He's got all kinds of stuff in here. He's got furniture, there's couch, table set, stools. It's like, you can build your own Red Rocket with this mod. It's really fantastic. Got the doors, decorations. I wonder if he's got a gas pump. No way. Get right out of town. Thank you, Ethereon. Let's see. Where did that thing sit? It was right up. It's kind of, there was the door. And then there was a little concrete embankment, and then it came right off. So yeah, it was right about here. Oh, that's fantastic. Let's see. What's the difference between the two? Are they different? It's even got the old numbers like that. That one did. It's hilarious. All right. Let's just do that. And there you go. Let's see what else. I wonder. I don't know if it would look good. We were talking about what kind of a decoration we could put on the side of it. I don't know if this would work or not. Huh. I don't know. I kind of like it, but it sort of takes away from the memories in a way. Yeah, I don't know. That's a possibility. But we do have our lettering, and I wonder, I'll have to get up there with a ladder, and then I'll spell it all out, and that'll come back, and we'll come back to that. But let's see, we've got, that's great. That is just so awesome. That's great. Let's have a look here. For a counter that we can put in. Let's have a look here. Northland Diggers Creative Clutter. This is made by the guys that do Dino's, what is it, Do It Your Shelf. Took me a minute to think of that. Resources. Well, it wouldn't be resources. Crafting stations. I'm trying to think. I thought they had stores. Like countertops. Who am I thinking of? chances. Ha! That's pre-war. Go post-war. Put some displays up. Of course, I'll have to put some electricity in here. But stuff like this. Once it's lit, it'll look a lot better. Oh, out of wood. I'm going to have to go buy some wood. Well, that's all right. Old time printing press. Yep. Well, okay. But to build a general store. There it is. Mr. Bosler's general store from whenever I was a kid. We would come up. We would walk up here and hang out underneath the awning, hang out in the doorway and wait for the bus, and the bus would come up the road from that direction. We would stay here, mess around with the old gas pump. Couldn't get in anymore though, but you could kind of see in through the old windows where they weren't boarded up. But when I was a kid, I'd walk right in here, and the counter was right here. Yep, it was great. Advertisements everywhere, and candy, and yeah. We'll see it. Once I get it decorated, we'll come right back to it. So, stay tuned. And after that quick little break there, thanks to editing, we are back. And here is our market. This is the Bosler General Store. And I added some steps here, and I moved the gas pump over to this little chunk of concrete that's coming off the foundation. It just seemed to look better there. It stands out a bit. And we've got our market sign up there all lit up. Got some neon. Got a place for people to sit. Little bobbers that for fishing. Ice cooler. And you come inside. And here it is. Over here is where the counter used to be. And we've got a little shelf with some Nuka-Cola guys on it. Shelf back there with some Vim. Got a radio. Vault-Tec. All the supplies you'll ever need, except steak knives. Some of you not might know where that comes from. Probably most of you. Got some bobbers hanging up there. We've got shelf full of all kinds of stuff. Paint cans and anything you might need around Sanctuary. He sells it. Sugar bombs right there up on the shelf. Got a little broken fridge that he's using kind of like a cooler. And we've got our Nuka-Cola and our Sunset Sarsaparilla machine. And then right here we've got shelving with clothing. Because we've got our clothing desk over here. Counter, I should say. Got a couple of mannequins. And there's some clothes on a shelf. Or actually on a rack. She's got some ironing there. This is probably where Ann will be, and then that'll be Vault-Tec over there. He'll be working that. And Minuteman flag, we've got our lights up, everything like that. I was thinking about this back room, and I'm probably going to put a bed back here, and this is where Vault-Tec can live. He can have his store and just come out and go to work every morning. He'll probably like that. course, we got the albino rad stag heads up on the wall. And Bert ducks and covers. That's an old civil defense poster. Trash can. It's looking pretty good. Yeah. It's definitely very similar to how I remember the old general store from when I was a kid. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you enjoyed it. I had fun making it, and I hope you guys will tune in again sometime. Check out what we build next and all the adventures that we have in the Commonwealth. I'm Izzy Smith, and until next time, take it easy.
And now, folks, it's time to say goodnight. We sincerely appreciate your patronage and hope we've succeeded in bringing you an enjoyable evening of entertainment. Please drive home carefully and come back again soon. Good night.